A chemist has three different acid solutions. The first acid solution contains 10% acid, the second contains 40% acid, and the third contains 60% acid. The chemist wants to use all three solutions to obtain a mixture of 100 liters containing 45% acid. The supply of 40% acid is low, so twice as much 10% solution as 40% solution must be used. How many liters of each solution should be used? So because we have three different solutions, we'll have to assign three variables to represent the amount of each solution. So let's let x equal the amount of 10% solution, y equal the amount of 40% solution, and z equal the amount of 60% solution. And because we want 100 liters of 45% solution, we'll be able to write two equations from this information. Since these are the amounts of each solution, x plus y plus z must equal 100 liters, or 100. Next, we know the concentration of the 100 liters must be 45%. So now what we're going to do is multiply the concentration times the amount of each solution, and the sum of that should be equal to the 100 liters of 45% acid. So we'll convert these percentages to decimals and then multiply by the amount. Well, 10% as a decimal would be 0.10, or just 0.1. So we can say 0.1 times x plus 40% as a decimal would be 0.4, so plus 0.4y plus 60% as a decimal is 0.6, so 0.6 times z must equal the concentration of the mixture, which is 45%, or 0.45, times the amount, which is 100 liters. So we have the concentration times the amount plus the concentration times the amount, plus the concentration times the amount, must equal the total concentration times the total amount. And then finally, we're told that the supply of the 40% acid is low, so twice as much 10% solution as 40% solution must be used. So we'll use twice as much 10%, so x will be twice as much as the 40%, or x will be twice as much as y. So if x is twice as much as y, then x would have to be equal to 2 times y. Whatever y is, x would be 2 times y. So this is a system of equations that we want to solve for x, y, and z. Let's do this on the next slide. Notice how on the right side here we have 0.45 times 100, which would just be 45. So we'll go ahead and write this as 45 on the next slide. Now for the next step, we want to form two equations with just two unknowns, which we'll then solve using elimination or substitution, and then perform back substitution to find the values of the remaining variables. To do this, let's use substitution, since for this third equation we know x must equal 2y. So if x is equal to 2y, we can substitute 2y for x here and here in the first equation, which will give us two equations with just y and z. So for this first equation, we would have 2y plus y plus z equals 100, or 3y plus z equals 100. Let's go ahead and call this equation 1. Now I'll perform the same substitution into the second equation here, which would give us 0.1 times 2y plus 0.4y plus 0.6z equals 45. We could have cleared these decimals from this equation by multiplying everything by 10, but let's go ahead and leave the decimals in. So now we would have 0.2y plus 0.4y plus 0.6z equals 45. Combining like terms, we have 0.6y plus 0.6z equals 45. So we'll go ahead and call this equation 2. So now we'll solve equation 1 and 2 as a system of two equations with two unknowns. Let's go ahead and rewrite these. We have 3y plus z equals 100, and we have 0.6y plus 0.6z equals 45. Notice how we can easily solve this first equation for z and then perform substitution into the second equation. So if we solve this for z, we would subtract 3y on both sides. We'd have z equals 100 minus 3y. So now we'll substitute 100 minus 3y for z in the second equation, which would give us 0.6y plus 0.6 times 100 minus 3y equals 45. Let's go ahead and finish solving this equation here on the next slide. So we'll distribute. We would have 0.6 times 100 is 60, and 0.6 times negative 3 would be negative 1.8, or minus 1.8y equals 45. Combining the y term, this would be negative 1.2y plus 60 equals 45. Subtract 60 on both sides. That would give us negative 15 divided by negative 1.2. And this gives us y equals 12.5. Remember, y was the amount of liters at 40% solution. So let's go ahead and write that down. We know that there are 12.5 liters of 40% solution. But we still have to find x and z. But now that we know that y is equal to 12.5, we can use this equation here to find x. X would be equal to 2 times y, which again we know is 12.5. So x is equal to 25 liters. So again, going back to the first slide, we can now say there are 25 liters of the 10% solution. And then finally, we know that x plus y plus z must equal 100. So going back to the other slide, using this first equation here, we now know that 25, which is x, plus 12.5, which is y, plus z must equal 100 liters. This would be 37.5 plus z equals 100. Subtracting 37.5 on both sides, we have z equals 62.5, which would be the number of liters at 60%. I hope you found this explanation helpful.